Good evening, everyone. My name's Heath Haskins, Good Primate, and welcome back to another Woodmill Incorporated. Nailed it. Oh my gosh. It's also known as WMI. That's what I call it, but that's also what I think a lot of other people have started calling it, just because we're like Windmill or Lumber 3 or... Like we've all said the different names. We all have made the different things. Woodville. There's been all kinds of names for this thing, but it's Woodmill Inc. WMI. So I got the big car last time, but we don't have any wood, so I need bigger lands and bigger things. That's what I'm going to do this episode. I do have the chat turned off, and I've already warned everybody. I said, hey, I'm not ignoring you. I promise I am like here. I just can't hear you. So let's go see what these new sawmills have got in store for us. I've got 2,400 on me. Let's see. What is this? That's conveyors. Conveyor belts. That's the one seater. That's the basic mill, right? What is this? Large mill. Upgraded mill. So there's a large mill. How much is that? 12,000. I don't have 12,000. What is this one? 6,000. I don't have 6,000. Wait, how much do I have? I got 2,000. Clothes. What is this? That's the funnel conveyor. Okay, so none of that stuff we need. Not right now. But I did hear a little secret. I'm not gonna give away dev secrets. So the stuff that the developers are creating, they're like, hey, can you not put those on video or like wait until we release them? Like, yeah, I can do that. I can comply. So one thing that I did ask about that I was told I could show, because I have ideas for it, is this little thing right over here. Come on, boom. Boom, boom. Do the boom. Did it do it? It didn't do it. It didn't do it. Okay, so that's broken. Or it just doesn't work. Either way. Let's go get some wood and get a bigger mill. That's what I need right now. Hi, buddy. Hi, everyone. If you'll also notice, I am playing on public servers now. So I'm able to hang out with people instead of worrying about stuff. Wait, would it behoove us to do oak trees versus going all the way up here to get these? Or maybe some elm trees? I think it takes longer to cut elm, doesn't it? Oh no, what happened to the sound? Oh, there it is. So, somebody's been chopping. Look at that. So I have an idea. Okay. How far down can we throw this stuff? So I don't have to walk all the way back up here. I'm just gonna do this. Watch. We're gonna chop right here. Thank you. And thank you. Oh, thank you very much. Throw it right down here. There you go. Good. Now, same thing for over here. So, same principle. If you drive off backwards, it's going to be more stable. There you go. And the reason for that is because the back end or the front end has got a lot more objects on it, and it's a lot heavier. So you want the lighter end going down first. Whereas if you were ramping it like off of a ramp, you're kidding me. Hold on. Come here. Skills. I was worried there for a second. I'm like, you did not just do that. Flip. Whee. On down you go. Good deal. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to chop all these down, and then I'm going to leave them right there at the ramp. That way I don't have to go all the way back up this thing just to grab the trees and the logs. Come on. Down you go. Not here. You gotta keep going. Keep going, buddy. Come on. There you go. No. Don't throw me down. I don't want to go down there. How's the sound? Is it too loud? No? Maybe not? There we go.
But we are recording, right?
Yeah, we're 5 minutes in. Yay. So, school is getting ready to start for some of the U.S., and I've seen a couple of high schools that are requiring the mandate of masks again and stuff, which, if you've been vaccinated, why would it be a requirement for the mask? Just saying. Like, I'm not arguing the points, but, what is it, up to the age of 12 can now get the vaccine? Which, that's something very controversial, but it's something that, like, a lot of kids have questions about. You have questions about the vaccine, what does the vaccine do, what are the side effects of the vaccine, stuff like that. I'm not going to discuss it or get into the details of it. Just know that I believe in the vaccine, okay? I also believe in, I believe in getting stuck in the seats. What in the world is this? Please let me back up. Thank you. No, just get out of the seat. Getting ran over. Jump away from it. Jump away. Okay. I believe in the mask and I believe in the vaccines, and I think it's still a very big problem. You know, I think the Delta variant and all this other stuff that's coming along, it's a result of us not killing it fast enough, not heeding the warnings and following through. Too many people I know personally are like, I don't believe in it. I don't believe that it's a thing. I think it's a conspiracy theory. I'm like, really? I mean, conspiracy theory, to each their own. And you can believe whatever you want. I'm not here to influence you. But I personally believe strongly in masks, and I believe in vaccinations. And I think they work. I know they work. So, like I said, I can't convince anybody, but hopefully I can talk to people, give my opinion. Also, weren't we supposed to have some way of flipping our cars? Just saying. Holy cow, you guys. Thank you. They're all coming over to help me. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Hi, buddy. Hey, how you doing? Hold on. Let me get my car out. Hi, bud. Ooh, I got a shiny car. The reflection on that thing was high. Did you see that? I had to blind myself. Ah! Now, should I chop it over here and then just lift it up and take it over there? Or should I try and stack these things? Because we all know that the wood is quite unstable inside this game. And you can't jump in the vehicle quite as easy as you could in lumber. I'm not trying to make a comparison, but some of my little tricks that, oh gosh, some of my little tricks don't work so well as they did on the other game. Oh gosh. Okay. That is not going to work. Okay. I think we're gonna chop it. Let's go. Let's go, buddy. Can you not chop it when it's on the car? What? Yeah, you can chop what's on the car. That was weird. Hold on. Sorry about that. Had a little boogie, like, hanging out. I don't know if it was on camera or anything, but that was... Ew. Didn't want to, like, just reach out and be disgusting, like... Argh. Nope, not happening. Not on camera. Not on my camera. Now, did I lose ownership of that one? I don't know. I don't know what happened. Oh, no. Will Wells. The bane of my lumber existence. I mean, as a lumberjack, not lumber tycoon too. There we go. Boink. Oh, that one was not chopped. That's not chopped. Come on, choppy chop, chop chop chop. You know what? It's good. Let's go. Let's go. Oh, scoop, scoop. Ooh, it almost didn't have enough power to take that. What? Much quicker though. You might need to increase the torque of the tires. Just saying. Yay. Okay. Okay. Move structure. Uh-oh. Hold on. Do we need to get it further in? Is it too long? Oh, yeah. There it goes. Magic. I think it upset some of the devs that I was able to figure this out and, like, do the move structure thing. But it's okay. I still think it's an amazing system. Amazing. Some of these will just go straight through, right? Ooh, the moon just came out. Nice. Will that go in? Will that go in? Ooh. Oh, come on. There we go. Oh, dang it. All right, now it's gonna be stuck under there, isn't it? Come on. Come on, okay. Hold on. Maybe we can do this. Maybe I can do move, click. Aw, oh, missed. All right. Move, click. There, I got it. Set it right on top, and it's gotta be like just over that green area. And then it just drops straight in. Come on, drop straight in. It is, it's too big, it's too big. No, whoa. Did it just get pulled in from the underside? That's crazy. Maybe try this side. Hold on. Here we go. If we aim it like this, good. I think it might be too big, possibly. Right there. Move. There it goes. Sweet. Just didn't have it in there far enough, that's all. Come on, please. Please go. Good deal. This one's definitely too big, isn't it? 30 units big. Hold on, let's try it. I'll try it real quick. No, it worked. All right, here we go. Good. Nice. Nice, so nice. Okay, let's go ahead and get these out of here. We'll go sell some of these off, see how much money we get. Maybe I can get a bigger, just a little bit bigger sawmill than the one I've got. Maybe grab some conveyor belts to help us out here. What do you think? Okay, grab this, lay it down, get in there. Get in there. Nope, you gotta lay flat. Gotta lay flat, bud. Come on. There we go. That'll work. So, let's put this at the end like this. I'm gonna rock this up like that. And this should get stuck on the back of the chairs. Ooh. See that? Glitchy wood. Come on. Get in there. Good, good. Good. Why is it being all weird? Anyhow, I was also told that there are private servers for content creators that won't need to, like, buy a private server. I think. I saw Cam. He was doing it somehow with command line. Just pretty cool. I've also had a lot of people contact me about putting different pictures. Like, somebody wanted a Doge picture inside the game. I'm going to tell you this. Anything is possible. Okay, we could put a Doge picture in there. Now, do we want to? I don't want to. I want to put in, like, meaningful pictures of YouTubers and content creators and accomplishments, you know, stuff like that. But again, I'm not the lead developer. I'm not the person making all the decisions. So I will bring the option, bring the ideas that you guys have in the comments to all the people, to all the devs. If you want your suggestion to be seen and not just a comment, I highly suggest you check out the Woodmill Incorporated Discord. We have a suggestions channel in there where you can produce all of your suggested comments and get a response. So there's a lot more to this game, a lot more to what did you do? How in the world did you do that? You know what? I don't know. I don't know how you did that. But that looks awesome. That is one cool thing that you can do inside this game, is you can build at angles. So a lot of people were like, hey, Code, can we get corner pieces? And I'm sitting here thinking, you can produce corner pieces if you know how to place things. Like, I don't even know if glitch builds work. We might have to try that out. Hold on. Did that just not go in correctly or what? There we go. There it goes. So, like, here, I'll have to show you the glitch building later. Probably once alpha starts, a lot of people are going to figure out some of the little glitch things that you can do inside this game. Come on. Ah, dang it. Push me back. No, wait, can I do this from the side? Hold on. Oh, nice. You can do it from the side. It's not quite as impressive, but still works. All right. So we hit move, go forward, grab, grab. There it goes. Just gotta hit that sweet spot, and that will produce these things. Now, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get 6,000. How long have we got? We've got about 10 minutes left. So, I'm gonna keep encouraging you to purchase the game. You don't have to purchase the game. The game will be free. A lot of people are still asking the question, when will it be free? It'll be free at the end of July, beginning of August. And there's a lot of people being very snarky, like, oh, you mean 3 years? No, I don't mean 3 years. I mean literally at the end of July, beginning of August, this game will be free to play. You can come in and play and have fun. In fact, you can go and purchase private servers if you want. Yeah, you can even get your own private servers. Right now, there is no private server because we have it in pre-alpha. Like, it's in the pre-alpha. It's like, it's not even produced yet. It would be like going to Subway and asking if you can have some of their dough. Like, yeah, you could grab some of the dough, but they're going to charge you for it, right? Dough is not free. But once that dough is baked, then you get it free when you purchase a sandwich, right? That's a bad analogy. That means that you'd have to purchase the sandwich. This would be like getting a free sandwich, but if you're wanting the dough beforehand, then you have to pay for the dough. Does that make sense? I don't know. That makes no sense at all. Anyhow, I'm very glad that they did it, that we did it, that we decided for 800. A lot of people are like, that's too expensive. I'm like, you know what? The guys that are creating this stuff, they're kids. They're, no offense to the developers, all right? You are kids, all right? And this is a great opportunity to create a Roblox career. And in fact, to show you that what you make inside Roblox, it really does matter. It counts. People like what you're producing. Given time, given your experience and everything else, guess what? Even if you don't do Roblox games in the future, you can put this, what you've done, on a resume. That's phenomenal. In fact, I encourage anyone that's out there, if you've ever produced a Roblox game of some kind and you're going into the workforce, use that on your resume. Use it as part of your portfolio. You know, people listen to that. People understand. And if they don't, then you need to find a different job. Because this here, it's not just a kid's game. A lot of people still think Roblox is just a kid's game. It's not. It is a hello, hi, hey, thank you. I think he's taking it to my plot. Thank you. It is a highly, highly integrated physics machine that kind of looks like a little kid's game. A lot of people compare it to Minecraft. It is not Minecraft. Minecraft is programmed in Java, and Java is a programming language. So I want you to think of Roblox as being the Java language that creates Minecraft. A lot of people say, do you play Roblox? Well, technically, you play Roblox games. Roblox itself, you don't play Roblox. You play Roblox games. It's kind of like saying, do you play Epic? That's what it's like saying, do you play Epic? Well, no, you play Fortnite. Fortnite is an Epic game created with Epic's Unity. It's not Unity, it's Unreal Engine. But it's not a game itself. Epic is not a game. Right? Food for thought. Oh, there we go. Okay. Let's see if I can do this without losing the tree. No! Oh gosh, oh gosh. No. Dang it. Hey, I'm still driving here. Nice. Okay. It's losing its limbs. It's leaves. Alright. So, I'm just going to prop you up like that. Set you down like that. Maybe move you a little bit forward, because that's... There we go. So now I should be able to grab like this. Nice. I love the ability to grab that entire tree and just drive it down. That's awesome. No. Stay. There you go. Nice. That's so cool. Thank you. Andy chopped it all up for me. Thank you. I appreciate it. Oh, I thought the tree disappeared. Now, I've always wanted to do this, but I don't think... There's definitely a limit to how much wood you can put in there. And Akoza was telling me it's 30 units. So if anything is bigger than 30 units, it will not plank out. It looks at you and goes, no, I don't think so. So, just remember, bigger than 30 units, it's a no-go. Smaller than 30 units, you might have a chance. Hold on, let's see if this is, see if I can do the big one. Oh, snap, look at that. Don't have to wait. I bet that one's bigger than 30 units. What do you think? Bigger than 30 units? Yeah? Come on, come on, come on. Please, please, please. Do it. Do it. No. Okay, fine. Okay. Maybe if I just chop off one of these. Just one? There we go. We'll send that one through by itself. Hopefully it doesn't get stuck by that other one that's trying to plank as well. Oh, it's gonna get stuck. Okay. Wood? Wood? Alright, hold on. Nope, I did it too fast. Move, grab. There we go. Okay. So let's turn you. Spin you right round, baby, right round. Drop you right here. And move. I'm lightning for dark now? What does it say? Boom. Look at that. Beast mode. What do you say? I can't hear you, buddy. I'm sorry. I keep turning off my chat and only the bubble stuff comes up. Come on. Come on, move my car. Move my car. There we go. I need a custom plate. That's gotta be bigger than 30 units. You know? Ooh, ooh, lights, camera, action. Oh, there we go. Had to wait for the moonlight to come up. There we go. By the way, it might not look so smooth on my camera because I just realized I think I'm running 30 frames per second. 6,000. 700. 6,791. I think that's enough to get the next level. And remember, if you do buy, oh gosh, if you do buy access, and if you do jump in here, it's all getting deleted. All this. It's this save, this axe, everything's gone. Okay, once the it releases, it's going full-fledged game. Okay, let's go ahead and grab the upgraded sawmill. Hey, David. Do I want to buy that for 6,000? I do. Thank you. Now, a lot of people say, hey, just leave it there and open it on the way. Open it and take it to your base. I prefer to open it on the way to my base. Here we go. Let's go here. Nice. Now, how big And this one accept. And what's the Y? 1.4? It's still not that big. I mean, that's kind of tiny. So, check this out. I'm going to move this structure up here on a tree. That way it's at an angle. But it's off the base. So, I'm still upset. This isn't opening for me, so I can't give it away. Hi, buddy. Dude, nice. I like your avatar. Yay. So we're ready. We're ready for bigger things. That's 30 minutes. Oh my gosh. That took 30 minutes just to get that sawmill, which I'm very happy about. Thank you everyone for watching this episode of Woodmill Incorporated with me, Heath Haskins, Code Primate. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe down below. Do all those cool things I'm supposed to call out at the end of the videos. Remember, a lot of people are going to be like, oh, you think you're unique and everything else. You are unique. You're an individual person and there's nobody else in the world who's just like you. I love you for that. Be unique. Be you. Stand up for what you believe in. Even if you have to stand alone. I love you guys. Have a great night. We'll talk to you soon.
Outro.
Want some new merch? Check out teespring.com.
Outro.